professor named Geppetto. I'll be very lonely. I have nobody to talk to. I want all day making chairs and tables. But now I need to do something different. Something I have never done.
So he took a piece of pine wood and started making a puppet. He worked all day carving each detail.
How beautiful it is! How I wish that he were a real boy. I have always wanted to have a son. Your name will be Pinocchio. That night, when Geppetto was sleeping, a fairy came to his hut.
Pinocchio, it is true. You are beautiful. And with my magic wand, I will give you life.
Then the puppet opened his eyes and started moving slowly.
Pinocchio, I want you to be a brave, honest, and generous boy. So every time you tell a lie, your nose and your ear will grow. And when you tell the truth, they will be normal again.
Then the fairy disappeared. Next morning, when Geppetto woke up, he heard someone calling him.
Father, father!
Who's calling me?
It's me, Pinocchio. Don't you recognize me?
It seems like I am dreaming. Finally, I have a son.
A few days later, Geppetto started thinking about Pinocchio's education.
Pinocchio, you need to go to school.
But, father, I want to be with you always.
So glad, Pinocchio, but you have to learn. I want you to be a smart boy. I cannot teach you many things that you can only learn in school.
Then I will go to school. I will study hard so that I can have a good job and earn a lot of money.
We don't need the money, Pinocchio. We are happy the way we live. I know, father, but I want to buy you a coat.
Very well. But now, go to school. It's getting late.
Goodbye, father.
Goodbye, Pinocchio.
When Pinocchio was on his way to school, he heard a man shouting,
"Come in, ladies and gentlemen. Come and see a puppet show."
A puppet show?
Wow, puppets like me? I have to go and see them.
So, Pinocchio, instead of going to school, he went to see the puppet show.
Oh, I am so happy that I want to dance with them. I can dance and sing better than this puppet, and I don't need strings like they do.
Get off my stage.
Then when the audience saw that he didn't have strings, they started shouting,
"Yeah, yeah!"
They liked him. "Boy, they want you to be in our show. You can earn a lot of money."
"No, because I have to go to school."
"Then take these coins. You danced very well."
"Thank you, sir."
And Pinocchio left the show and started walking to school. Then he heard somebody calling him.
"Well, well, well. Are you in a hurry, little boy?"
"Yes, I am going to buy a coat for my father."
"Oh, come on. That's not enough money to buy a coat. Wouldn't you like to have more?"
"Yes, but how?"
"That's easy. If you plant your corn in the field of miracles, a plant will grow and it will give you a lot of money."
"And what is that field?" "We will take there."
So the cat and the fox, who in fact were two lions, took Pinocchio to a faraway place.
"Is this the place?"
"Yes, it is. It is the place where you will give us your money."
and left him there all by himself.
When suddenly